Hi everybody, I'm Ros Cuthbert from the Art Shed Winscombe. Today I want to put the Hake through its paces, the Hake brush, and we're going to do some studies of cats with a round brush and then a kind of cat portrait with the round and the Hake. Here's my 1-inch Hake, and first of all I'm going to put this through its paces. So it's a brush which is made of goat hair, and goat hair is not as springy as sable or imitation sable brushes, so it handles a little bit differently. The toe or the tip of this brush is obviously quite a long shape, and bouncing and dancing on the tip you can get a little broken mark. Coming further down into the middle of the hairs, the belly, you can get quite a nice continuous shape, quite a nice continuous brush mark. And Hakes are good for washes for this reason. You can also, especially if you spread the hairs a little bit, you can get a broken line. And this will happen naturally as the brush starts to run out of paint or ink. It is possible to make quite a fine line with a Hake if you just take it along on the tip. You can make quite a fine line. And obviously you can make a broad line. And then if you angle it, you can also make a line which is less broad, or more broad. It's very good for zigzags. It has a kind of natural italic quality, being short and then wide stroke. And you can make all kinds of, if you twist it and turn it, you can make all kinds of very eloquent, lovely marks with it. You can also turn it back on itself and make wilder marks. And you can even, if you hold it at the tip, a bit like this, you can even spin it on one of its corners and make a circle, which is fun. So there are lots of other marks you can make with the Hake. You can just work on a corner for more detail if you want to, without having to change brushes. You can layer marks and so on as with other brushes. Okay, so that's a little introduction to the Hake. Before I start doing my cat portrait, I'm going to warm up with some quick sketches of a group of cats. I've got two photographs here in front of me, and I'm going to use, first of all, a pencil. Just to do some quick studies. Although I'm working from a photograph, I'm not working in a laborious way. I'm just trying to capture the essence of cat. Next one. It's important to keep the brush or pencil moving and not to be judging what I've done as I go along. I'm just simply trying to pay attention and get as close as I can to the cat, I think, the cat I'm drawing, without kind of being laborious and without sort of stopping the pencil. So I'm trying to keep the pencil moving and my eye moving quickly back and forth to try to grasp the nature of the animal's stance. It's fun. As you get into it, you start to feel more confident and not mind if the drawing is a little bit wobbly and inaccurate. Just keep working at it. And at some point, the thing will click in. I can't see this cat back there, but it's masked by another cat, so I'm going to just invent it. And maybe one more. So as I draw, my eye is busy making comparisons, going hither and thither across the form of the cat in the boudoir to compare shapes and relative positions, say of the features and the limbs and so on. And I can't see the cat's tail here, so it's the top of the other side. And try to get a sense of it. Okay, I've done a few studies with my pencil. I'm going to try a few now with my brush. So I think I'll take a number 8 round and see how I get on with that. So I'll have a look at the other photograph. So I'm trying to draw with the brush, not making too much of a distinction between the brush and the pencil. It's doing a similar job that the pencil was doing. So I'm trying to stay on the tip to get a definition of the features. Obviously I can also quite easily put in the light and shade with the brush. So the back of his cap disappears off the edge of the photo, so I'm just going to imagine it's got a tail. Just to put that in for fun. So quickly on to the next one, before my judgmental brain has time to start criticizing, self-criticizing. On to another one. Looks like a young cat in the front here. Yeah. And perhaps one more. Much heavier cat than the others. Yeah, so perhaps that would be enough. So fill a page with some studies, both with a pencil and with a brush. Get limbered up. And now I'm going to start on the cat portrait. I've got the drawing sort of touched in here to speed things up a little. I shall make it stronger so that you can see it. And I'll point out also that in the proportions of this cat, this archetypal pose of cat sitting looking at you, the face from the top of the forehead here to the chin is 1, 2, 3, about four, almost four times divisible into the length. So if you mark that out, you can get the proportions of the cat's pose. You can see the elbow tucked in to the fur on this side. You can just see the forms of his forelegs. So when I paint that, it's going to have to be painted so that I don't lose those shapes. They're quite subtle in the light and shade of the cat's fur. Okay, I think that might be enough information. Just to guide the brush. So I'm going to do it with a combination of Hake and round. I've already mixed up some colour using two pigments, using light red, sometimes called English red, and phthalocyanine blue. Light red and phthalocyanine blue. So it gives me a good grey. If I wanted to err on the side of a bluish grey, I can increase the amount of phthalocyanine blue. That will give me a bluish grey. I think I like the bluish grey, so I'm going to go ahead with that to start with. I'm going to try to do it in two layers of lighter and darker. We'll see how I get on. So using the side of my brush to make fine marks, to try to get the shape of the ear, leaving a little bit of light on the front edge of the ear. Splaying the hairs of the brush to try to get a little bit more fluffiness out of the mark where I need it. So this is going to be the underpainting. And even though I'm thinking of it as underpainting, I'm trying to start to build the direction of the cat's fur, the way it's lying. So you can see the lack of bounce in the hairs of the brush. The goat hair simply stays where it's put, much more than sable. So it takes a little bit of adjusting to that. If you're used to sable or imitation sable brushes, your watercolour. I find this 1-inch Hake quite versatile. I'm used to it. I like the way that it stays in place. Obviously, it was designed to do that. So So that's the first layer of color. And I'm now going to change to watercolor black. I have a little bit here. Just checking if the blackness is not black enough yet. Better. I think before I go further with the Hake, I'm just going to go to on my number six round and define the features just a little bit whilst the rest of the painting is drying. It's got some little hairs which are catching the light, whiskers, but I'm going to put those in at the end with white gouache. Of course, you could use your masking fluid for that as well, or you could use white ink. So if I make short marks with the Hake and pull the brush out of the movement, I can get soft, fluffy kind of marks. Because the cut is so dark, I'm trying to be careful to leave the highlights where I see them. turning to the round, just a couple more details. And I'm going to, if she's dry enough, to put in just a little bit of green for the eyes. And a little bit of a tear bit. And while I'm working from a black and white photograph, I know there is a little bit of pink in the colour of the photograph about the ears, so I can just hint at that as well. I'm also going to use this pink, which is actually earth pink. It's English red, again, English red or light red, or red ochre, sometimes it's called. It's your reddest red-brown. And I've got a little bit mixed up here. I'm just going to give the cat a little bit of context. A bit of earth to the city. Okay. A bit fanciful as well. Mix around. And finally, viscous. So I'm going to use a rigger. A rigger is a very long, fine, long-haired brush. This is a number two, rigger number two. And I'm going to use my brush. I'm going to turn it upside down to do the other side because it's easier to bring the brush across from left to right as I'm right-handed. There she is. I think I'll leave her like that.